Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav from Automation Step by Step. And in this session, we are going to learn and look at the prerequisites and setup for Karate Automation Framework. So the very first thing we need is Java. Now, do not worry. We do not need to learn Java. We just need to have Java set up on our systems. And for that, you can go to your system. In case you are on Windows, you can go and open your command prompt. So I will search cmd and open my command prompt and then just say java space hyphen version and check if Java is installed. Now in this case for me it shows Java 15 is set up, so that is fine. In case you are on Mac, again you can go to your terminal. I'm pressing command spacebar on my keyboard to bring up spotlight search, and now I will search for terminal app, and here again on the terminal app you can say Java space hyphen version. This is for Mac, and again on my Mac I have Java 8 installed. So you just have to check if Java is available, and Karate requires at least Java 8, and you can also use OpenJDK. Now just in case you do not have Java set up on your system, you can go and check my tutorial. I will go on my website automationstepbystep.com, and here you will find a playlist for Java under programming section. You can see here we have a Java topic. This will take you to my YouTube playlist, and here you will find videos on how to install Java on Windows, how to install and update Java on Mac, and just in case you are using AWS Linux, you can also see this, how to install update Java on AWS Linux. So this will be easy. Just in case you do not get response to this command Java space hyphen version, you can check this. So the environment variables should also be set. Let me very quickly show you. If I go to my computer or this PC and do a right click and go to properties, and here I go to advanced system settings and go to environment variables, and here you can see Java home is set here wherever I have my JDK folder, and also in my path environment variable I will have the location. So you can see here I have this Java home bin location. So this Java home is coming from the Java home environment variables and then the bin folder of that JDK. So this two paths and environment variables should be set, and then you can check on a new command prompt, you should get this Java version. So this was the first prerequisites, and now after having Java set up on our system, we need some platform where we can write our tests and we can run and check our results, and therefore we need a IDE, that is Integrated Development Environment. And we have multiple options. We can use Eclipse IDE or IntelliJ or VS Code or any other IDE where we can create these tests, we can write the BDD syntax and we can run them. So in this session I'm going to use Eclipse, and for that you just have to get Eclipse. So if you go to the browser, if you go to your browser and go to search for download Eclipse, this will take you to the Eclipse website, which is eclipse.org, and here you can see you can just download directly from here, or you can click on download packages. And here you can search for Eclipse IDE for Java developers, and then based on your operating system you can just click here. So I will click on Windows 64, and then if you click here it will download a zip folder that you can unzip and keep at any location on your system. In my case I have kept my Eclipse folder here, so you can see this is my Eclipse folder after unzipping, and this is the Eclipse. So I can start Eclipse like this and it will start our Eclipse. I have a video on this as well, just in case you want to check. So here is a video getting started with Eclipse IDE. Just in case you are completely new to Eclipse, you can watch this as well. So this will start Eclipse. So you should have an IDE, and then we need some platform for dependency management. Dependency management means the libraries or the softwares we need for our project. We need some way to manage all these libraries and dependencies, and for that we can have Maven or Gradle. Now in this case we are using Eclipse and we can use Maven, and you do not have to separately download and install Maven on your system. Eclipse has inbuilt Maven from the some recent versions of Eclipse. It is inbuilt in Eclipse, so you do not have to separately install Maven on your system. Only if later on you want to run Maven commands out of Eclipse separately from command line, then you may need it, and I have a video on that as well. Just in case you need, maybe you will need later, you can check that. So here I have Maven, but as of now we will not need it. Eclipse has inbuilt support for Maven. So this is what we will need, and once you have all this, we will start doing our project setup. So this is what we are going to do in the next session. If you have any questions or any doubts, you can let me know, and then we will start with the project setup.